sportsmanship playing on, a song going on right now.
Yeah!
Well, Howie, here we are. We've been waiting about 3 or 4 weeks since the last time Hibbing and Chisholm met, and this is tip-off time.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of people that's been waiting. A lot of people have been waiting for this game, Phil. And we're certainly looking for a good game. And as you said before, we hope that Joel can stay healthy for the entire game here so we can get a true picture of what both teams really have.
The officials for tonight's game, Howie, I hear, are from St. Louis Park.
We are a room from St. Louis Park, originally from Hibbing.
Which ones are from Hibbing? Both of them?
No. The other one, Randy Gorey, called me about it after.
Okay, here we go. Tip-off time.
Yes, a good sign. Bruce Streak gets the tip-off, goes to Joel McDonald at the point.
Curious to see what kind of defense they're going to play against Joel.
Over and to the far side to LaCroix. Back out to Amick. Amick to LaCroix. Drives into the top of the key. A pass over to Amick. Puts the ball up with a nice fake. This is the ball. And number 20 comes down with the rebound.
There they go, Howie. Fast breaking. Just like the B team did. They're going to come out fast against us.
Right. Hibbing gets the possession off of this jump ball down there now. And of course, we don't want to, as we said before, we played them last time. We kept the Blue Jackets from fast breaking on the floor. There's an inbounds pass taken by Joel McDonald. Moves it down the floor. Top of the key. Pumps it up, and we have the first 2 points of the game. McDonald scores. Hibbing quickly gets the ball back on the floor. This is an easy shot. Price comes up with the rebound to Amick. And Amick over to McDonald at the top of the key. Dribbles to the far side of the three-point line. Out to Amick. To Price, turnaround jump shot. No good. Hibbing comes up with the rebound. Rash with the rebound.
We're going to have to watch number 42, Sadovich, on Joel McDonald. He's out there to play tough defense on him, but you're going to watch some elbowing out there. I hope the officials get to see it.
Again,
easy for the long shot. No good.
Price comes down with the rebound to LaCroix here on the side. Pass over to Amick.
Oh!
Misses.
Technical foul. He must have touched something,
the bank board or something. There's a technical foul here on Rash.
Looks like the officials are going to take control of the game immediately. I don't think either official has seen Hibbing or Chisholm before. Basket counts.
The basket is good, and McDonald will go to the line to shoot the technical.
Well, I think what happens is it doesn't have to go in.
Whatever it is, they
are on the cylinder. It'll be interesting to watch the video on this.
Slapping the backboard when the ball is up in the air over the backboard. McDonald misses the first technical foul. He gets one more. McDonald shoots the second one and it's down.
What's nice about the technical, we get the ball now.
That's right. Chisholm gets the ball back, and with 6:37 left in the first quarter, Chisholm's got five, and then we have a steal by Arnie. Nice pass into Sadovich, puts the ball up, he misses it. McDonald comes down with the rebound. Takes it down, loses the ball. Arnie's up with the ball. 2 points.
Four was Arnie. Arnie has two buckets.
The court comes up with the ball, loses the ball. Out to Rupert. Rupert loses the ball to Arnie.
Oh, it's time to settle down.
That's right. Can't get going too much in high gear and make the bad passes.
Nice ball by Price. Joel.
Arnie. Left side. Puts the ball up. And Kearney rumors them.
Hibbing's not going to be in the ball game very much longer. They're out there to hammer people, and that is not basketball.
Well, they're hammering the wrong guy, Phil, because as we all know, Joel, when he goes to the line, is a dead-eye free-throw shooter, so it's going to be to their disadvantage and our advantage.
I just want the fans out there to watch number 42. They're playing Joe McDonald.
Makes the first one, making the score 6-2.
Well, there's approximately 550 fans at tonight's game.
And there's the second one, bringing the score to 7-2 in favor of the Blue Streaks with 5:50 left in the first quarter. Kearney over to Ani. Ani down to Thiesing in the far corner. Pass inside to Rask, and they end up with an easy bucket there, and the score is now 7-4. Amick with the ball. Over to Lacroix, drives to the top of the key there, looks around, loses. Ball's tipped off the fingers of Rash. So the Blue Streaks will get the ball out of bounds in the far corner over here. Ball goes into Roofer. Roofer looks inside, nothing there. Back out to Joel. Way outside. The ball's off here. No rebound out of that one there. Amick gave a valiant try to try and tip that one back into bounds. But the Blue Jackets will end up with the ball here out of bounds. And with 5:17 left to go, 7-4, the Blue Streaks in the lead. Blue Streaks are now in a 1-2-2 zone press.
Arnie Donnie. And it's out of it. She traveled right there.
Arnie with a 20-footer. 2 points. Score 7-6 now. McDonald at the far corner, 3-point shot, and it's down. 3 points for Joe McDonald. The score is 10-6 in favor of the Streaks. Kearney with the ball over in the corner. Over to Ani. Back to Kearney. Inside to Sadovich. Turnaround jump shot, and his jump shot is good. 10-8. Blue Streaks in the lead.
Just can't give him those easy inside shots.
McDonald with another long one, no good.
There it is.
There's prize, good position on the board, Phil. Paid off. We've got the height advantage here, and I think if they can hang in there, it'll be to our advantage.
We might have to talk a little louder, Howie. The fans' noise is deafening. I can hardly hear myself.
It sure is. It's the kind of noise that keeps my adrenaline flowing, Phil. This is excitement.
The sophomore, number 40. In fact, I forgot his
name. Takes a three-pointer, no good.
Brian Thompson in the game, 40. There we go.
Lacroix got the ball.
Bring the ball up court. He's still hobbled with that hip-pointer. He's wearing a football girdle. There goes that silly bounce again. He came down twice with no points. I mean, we have to come down at least with a few.
Well, you gotta get down and get a good shot out of it. Bubba Kearney taking one from 25 feet out. No good. Another shot. McDonald
would have
down.
To have a slip shot to see that far.
Here comes McDonald down the center of the court. Slows it up. Looks around.
There's Ted.
Over to Ted on the inside. Takes it inside and it drops. There's two. A 6-foot jump shot from the paint.
This is Hawaii basketball at its finest. Good competition. Win or lose. Two good basketball teams out there.
Seizing in the ball with the right hand.
He's a
corner.
Sophomore, Howie. Number 40 is just a sophomore.
That's right, and a pretty good one at that, I may add.
He's averaging approximately 25 points a game. He's only an outside shooter, just very seldom drives to the bucket. So clearly, he can defense him. Kearney likes to drive. Good defense by the Streaks. Nice shot, Kearney.
Kearney gets a good shot there, and with 3:20 left, Chisholm's ahead by a score of 12-10. McDonald slowly takes the ball down the floor here. Shouting out some instructions for the players, backs up to the timeline. Over here to Lacroix. Lacroix looking inside for McDonald. McDonald back out past the three-point line. One-on-one against Kraczowski. Kraczowski falls down. No basket.
There's that fast break, Howie. We're telling you about.
You have to end up leaving somebody back on defense against Hibbing. But those two guards, Ani and Kearney, you cannot give them an easy shot. In my estimation, Phil,
that's an intentional foul.
That's an intentional foul, definitely. And it's the thing I don't like to see. It's the same thing he did last time we played him. He held McDonald out on the floor.
They got it.
They got him for an intentional foul.
And I'll tell you, I'd like to send a tape of this game to the athletic director over there to watch what a push play that was. And I'll tell you, if you know anything about basketball, that was strictly push. Push meaning feet.
McDonald misses the first of the two shots for the technical. No doubt about the second one, it's down. It was 13 to 12, with 2:47 left in the first quarter. Mystics also get the ball out of bounds.
I'll tell you, Joel McDonald, good basketball player. There's no way, no reason to tackle somebody around the neck, and you could see it's intentional. The officials called it that way, and that's how it is. LaCole for 3 points, no good.
Teasing with the rebound on the other side, over to Kearney. Coming down the floor, quick lead, looking to drive into the basket. There's the basket. Those two guys, Arnie and Kearney, they're quick down there, and you can't give them one little gap to the basket, or they'll take it in. Hibbing leading now 14-13 with 2:20 left in the game. Pass into Thompson, off Thompson's pad. Hibbing retains possession here.
Well, I'll tell you, if you watch this on tape, I know it was Chisholm's ball, but the officials saw it the other way. That's how it goes.
Great. That's the way you have to play. After whatever the officials call, they can't always make every call correctly the way they try. That's right.
I must say I'm impressed with my old college mate, though.
Ball on Dave LaCole. Looks like it was before the shot. After the shot.
It's a first team foul on Chisholm, and Hibbing's got three team fouls. Ball goes in to Ani, over in the corner to Kearney. Kearney lets loose. No good. McDonald with another
rebound. Are they in? Are they howitzers, Howie?
Yeah.
They're not even around. And that could be their downfall tonight. First time they played, they were hot. Right now they're trying to muscle Chisholm. And they're getting caught at it, Howie. It's too bad that the football team didn't go muscle them out there. It's the playoffs. If they want to play football, put the helmets on. This is basketball.
Well, that's going to be their fourth foul here, Phil. And we still have a minute 46 left of the...
It's going to hurt them, Howie. It's going to hurt them.
Of the first quarter. So it's going to tell its toll if they try and keep doing this, because they'll put us to the free throw line. McDonald with a 15-footer. No good.
Ani off the... There you go, fast breaking. Hit the backboard. Chisholm's ball.
And one thing, Phil, you got to say, these two officials here are really in on the play. There's no monkey business. All right, McCole coming down the floor here with the ball. Taking his time over in here to Amick. McDonald trying to cut across. Over to Kreis. Kreis looking around, takes it into the basket, puts the ball up. No good. Gets his own rebound, spins, puts the ball up. No good. Petrovic comes down with the rebound.
We're doing much better on the rebounding here. We're getting the second shot, sometimes the third shot.
That's right. You got to
do last Friday against the Falls.
Yeah, you got to do that to stay in the game.
There's teasing on the drive. Nice play. Excellent play.
The ball goes down and fall on Looper.
Biggest lead tonight if he makes this one. 4-point lead. Substitute.
Pachowski back in the game for Thiesing. Score is now 70-13 with a minute left. Hibbing on top. McDonald over to Amick. Amick brings it in.
They won't even guard Amick. You know that he doesn't shoot.
That goes
He's
got to
do something.
Back in the Kreis. Kreis eyes the bucket, puts the ball up. No
He's
good.
Short.
Petrovic with the rebound. In. On the floor. Amick with a good tip. Kearney tries to get the ball up.
Desperation. open shot by Carney.
McDonald coming down the center of the court. Brings the ball in, puts it up for a three-pointer. No good.
Rebound try.
Price
puts the ball up.
And it's good for two. The Sheiks pull within two at 17-15 with 20 seconds left in the first quarter.
I tell you, that's 100% effort. 120.
And there's a field goal.
I'll tell you, I think the fans are going to get their money's worth. I hope you're watching this on Channel 2. If not, call a, if you are, call a friend.
Arnie with the ball. The top of the key, over to Carney. Back to Arnie. To Carney.
They're going for one shot, Howie.
Dribbles in the top of the key. Puts the ball up and it's gone.
It's paid off.
1 second left. McDonald fires the ball down. It's no good. And at the end of the first period, we have the Blue Jackets on top with 19-15. At the end of the first quarter, McDonald has 9, but Carney has Carney has 10. Carney has 10 points. And one thing, Phil, that I think you have to look at here is the fact, and I've said it all along, both Carney and Arnie are very, very quick. And it makes it difficult out there because you not only have to watch them for the three-point shot, if you try and play them too tight, they'll go around you and pull up with about a 15-foot jump shot. So definitely the players on the top of the key for the Streaks have got their work cut out for them tonight.
Well, their guards are very quick, Ollie. They're going for that easy layup, and they're going to get it if we don't at least drop one guy back. There's a mental mistake. I'll tell you, at this time, Howie, things do not look good.
Looper's open, puts the ball up, and scores two. Looper for two. 21-17, 5-point lead for the Blue Jackets. Chisholm has now dropped back into a 2-2-1 zone press. Carney over into Kuchowski in the corner, back out to Carney. Carney across to Ani. Ani with a 25-foot shot, no good. Ball out to Carney. Carney puts it up, no good. Rebound by Looper. Out of McDonald on the far side. McDonald comes down, moves into the lane, stops, puts the ball up, and it's 2 points.
Nice to see us back in the ball game, Howie.
That's right.
For a while there, my heart was thumping, and I didn't think we were going to come around. Two mental mistakes, and bango, we're behind.
That's right, but now we're 21-19, we're just behind by two. There we go again, that quick speed by Ani gets around our point, man, but McDonald comes up with the rebound.
I'll tell you, they're not as hard as they were the first game. I think the foul problems that they're in.
McDonald for a three-pointer, in and out, no good. And Rash comes up with the rebound. Down to Carney. On the far side, pass into Ani. Ani, a fadeaway jump shot, no good. And Price comes down with a real power rebound. Over to Thompson. Thompson coming down. Lacroix with the ball. Lacroix over to Kreis. Kreis takes it into the lane and drops it for 2 points. And we've got a tie ball game here, Phil.
I tell you, it's patience, take your time, work it in, and you're going to get that easy puppy. We need those once in a while.
That's for sure. Kuchowski over to Rash with a turnaround, no good.
I don't know what Hibbing's doing, but they belong in a circus with some of the things they're doing right now. They're out of their game plan.
Here comes McDonald on the middle, stops, puts it up off the glass, no good. Nice poor rebound by Teddy Price, and he scores, putting the Blue Streaks in the lead, 23-21.
5:57 remaining, Holly. A lot of time, but the Streaks came back. He scored 6 straight points on them.
You betcha, another playing ball here, Phil.
What a big difference between the
two. They're running teasing on the baseline, looking to the inside. They're trying to throw it over Joel. It's not going to happen.
Right, out to Carney.
They're pushing him
out to
farther.
Carney on the top of the key, looking over. The teasing doesn't give it to him. Back out to Carney. Carney's got the lane on the right side. Now Thompson comes out to guard him. Gives it in to Kuchowski, a turnaround jump shot from about 12 feet, and there's Price.
Oh, here we go, they're in the circus again.
That's right, they're dominating that board. And it goes in for the basket, and a foul. Basketball, Phil.
Here we go. We're in the bonus, doesn't make any difference. We're getting that one shot.
That's right. A key rebound, an outlet pass, a nice pass to a breaking man down the floor, and we end up with a nice easy layup.
Ollie, that's a, if he makes this one, that's 11 point turnover for the streak. So down by six, it could be up by five or at least 10.
That's
that
right.
Means they haven't scored.
That's right.
For the last 2 minutes.
That's right. The score is 25-21 now with the streaks in the lead. Turning this thing around. The only thing is, no, like I say, Phil, we got to stop him from getting that fast break. That's the key. Lacour puts it up. 5 point lead with on Lacour's free throw. Ani comes down, a 25-footer, no good. Sadovich with the rebound out to Fiesing. He pumps in a three-pointer, and we've got a 26-24 ball game with the streaks up on top. Yes! Beautiful pass to the inside, and Rupo scores a reverse layup. Beautiful, here comes Fiesing again with another three-point play. That boy can shoot. There's no doubt about that. You can't give him the open shot.
I was at practice last night, and Coach McDonald told him exactly what to do on Fiesing, and they're not doing it.
There's Rupa powering up again. What a power move to the basket by Rupa.
It's best game so far. Rebounding and offensively.
And what a time to have it, though. Now the streaks are in the lead with 30-27 with 4:20 left in the second period. Ball in the corner to Fiesing. He's putting up another three-point shot. That's three in a row for Nick Fiesing, and we've got a tie ball game with 4 minutes and 8 seconds left to go. McDonald stops, pumps, hesitates, back out to Lacour. Lacour back over here to Thompson. Back to Lacour, back to Rupert, he fakes, puts the ball up, the ball goes down. Rupert has scored again on another power move to the basket. What a play, folks. That's what this team has got to have when you play a team at Lake Hibbing, Phil. You've got to get those other players involved because it takes the pressure off of McDonald, it takes it off of Lacour, and it takes it off of Kreis. And Rupert is certainly doing that tonight. 32-30. Rupert eyes the basket and hits the free throw for a three-point lead, 33-30 with 4 points left. Rupert's got 9 points already this quarter, and it's only half over. His best game by far. Let's hope it continues.
I'll tell you, Howie, like you said, Rupert helping out. Dave, let's go take a few shots. Now we're going to extend that lead. Get on Fiesing.
Yeah.
There you go.
Fiesing's got the hot hand right now.
Up front of him.
Yeah.
There's a block.
Yeah. And there's a foul on Sadovich. And now... Now, since we're in the 1-1 situation, Phil, that's just what I said. They try to get physical, it's going to cost them. And there's still 3.5 minutes left to go.
The second personal
foul.
Strip was
for
the district to the number 20,
Dave Capone. Dave Capone, a real good shooter. I'll tell you, as you get tired, that accuracy drops down. And we don't have much of a bench right now for a rest.
No good. Rash comes down with the rebound. Over to Fiesing on the side. Over to Ani over here in the far corner. Into Rash, bobbles the ball. And we've got a jump ball, folks. Possession will go to Hibbing. Possession goes to Hibbing. But that's what you have to do. When they wheel around with the ball, you got to get both hands on it. Fiesing tries an inside. Got to Rash. And scores it. That's one thing I've always said, Phil. Inside, when you're a big man inside, there's no sense in watching where the ball is because you take your eye off the cutters coming through. Now, if Rupert would have been turned around the other way and watching where Rash was, Rash wouldn't have got that ball inside.
All you have to do is really punt him.
No good. McDonald with the rebound. 33-32, the streak's up on top. 3:12 left to go in the second quarter. McDonald stops. Out to Kreis. Kreis looks, drives into the top of the key, and it's 2 points for Teddy Kreis. 35-32 with 3 minutes left.
I tell you, they're sagging off Joey Amick. It's almost like a double team to the inside, and Joe's having a hard time coming to the inside.
Right.
We need Joey to take that shot when he has it. Open up the game, just like Rupert's doing.
There, Ani with the ball in the right-hand top of the key from three-point range. Beautiful pass inside to Sadovich. And they have 2 points. The score is now 35-34. Chisholm has got the lead. McDonald stops, sets, puts it up. No good. Tries with the rebound. Looks back out to Amick. Amick at the top of the key. And he puts it down. That's what you've got to do. Those other players have got to help and chip in when they get the open shot, and they're doing it tonight.
There we are. Mental mistake. Mental mistake again. They're not dropping back. They're watching the ball. Absolutely right. Howie, I'd rather be ahead than behind. I'll take a 3-point, 2-point, and 1-point victory. It's a big W. And actually, this is a big game.
You betcha.
For the IRC Championship, they play each other twice.
That's right, and it's 2 points each time, and right now Chisholm's alone on top of the IRC standings with 5 wins, and I believe Hibbing is 2-2.
And I'll tell you, if it go down the wire, and if say Hibbing does beat Chisholm, they could basically win that championship.
Rash makes his second of 2 free throws with the score 37-36. There's 2 minutes left. The streaks are ahead. McCool calls a play. Crosses the timeline over here to Amick. Amick looks inside, nobody there. Back out to LaCole. LaCole comes into the lane. Pass in to Kreis. Teddy puts it up with 2 easy points. And the score is 39-36 with a minute 45 left in the second quarter.
Now we have a 3-point lead. We're going to be in good shape.
Well, that's what we have to do, I think, Phil. Coming into the last quarter, we've got to have a lead on them, because if, in essence, they get the lead, they've got the quickness out there, and it could make it mighty rough on us. Pass down to Rupert. Powers up and puts it in. Rupert with another 2, and the streaks are in the lead, 41-38. 3-point lead.
Bars possess 11 points.
11 points this second quarter alone. Pass inside, a miss.
Let's get down and get that good shot. 1:09. Let's not give it to them. Let's take a 5-point lead into the game.
McCool calling a play on the far side over to Amick. Amick takes it into the lane, powers up, and we got a foul on the play. Rash.
This is what I like to see. Joey Amick driving, taking the pressure. He could have passed it off. That's basketball, always. Everybody's involved in the game.
Right, and an important statistic here with 57 seconds, Phil, left in the second quarter. They have to pull Rash out of the game. He's got 3 points, and he's done a pretty amiable job in there so far. So that's an advantage for the streaks and a disadvantage here for the Blue Jackets. Amick hits the front end of the two shots that he gets from the charity line, making the score 42-38. And he hits the second one, Phil. The biggest. That's right. 5-point lead here with 53 seconds left.
Now a little defense, Howie. Yeah. Come back. There we are. No. There we are.
Nice. A tip by Rupert. Passed on to Amick. Amick puts the ball up and in. He scores. 35-38. But there we go again.
Hibbing.
Yeah.
He just gave it away. Why do we do that? Mental.
That's a tough pass, though. Baseball pass, full length of the court like that. It had to be, the needle had to be threaded. There's no doubt about that. LaCole with a 3-point shot. No good. Deasing with the rebound.
Howie, I really don't understand. With 15 seconds left in the quarter, we're taking a 3-point shot. We should have held on to the ball, worked it in. For the layup, got the ball. We could have been out of here with an 8-point lead. Now we're sending them to the free throw line. Instead of having an 8 or 7-point lead, it could be down to 2 or 3 points. It doesn't make sense to me.
Well, it usually doesn't, Phil, but you got to remember, these kids are in high school here, and the adrenaline is flowing down there, and the competition is so keen here. They want to win so bad and do everything they can to win, and sometimes they make the mistakes. That's Steezing making the first one. Now the score is 45-41. Chisholm with a 4-point lead with 15 seconds left to go before halftime. The second one's up and good. 45-42, 15 seconds left to go. Now I hope the streaks are looking at the clock at the time. 10 seconds. Over to 8 seconds. 6 seconds. 5 seconds, Lacroix drives in, and Tarupri powers up, and he makes the basket. The buzzer goes off, and the Streaks go into the locker room with a 5-point lead, 47-42.
That's exactly how he was just talking about before. The location, worked the clock down, went to the inside, got the two.
The team's 5-7, very easily.
What we're learning, and that's basketball in Harvey Rolls Arena.
I'll tell you.
For halftime entertainment, we're going to have a little basketball. We're going to zoom in, and you can sit there and watch little boys basketball. Howie has a wrap-up with sport with points before they're ready. Howie?
An important statistic here, I think, something which I'm sure Hibbing was not aware was going to happen, and that's that Mike Ruper has scored 13 points here in the second quarter, Phil. That's 13 points, and done just a yeoman's job. Just pouring up on the inside, taking it in there. I don't think anybody really expected this, but it sure is nice to see.
I like to see what's happening. Joey Amick's out there, he's in the ball game, he's driving, he's passing up, and he's shooting the ball. Now that takes pressure off Joel and the rest of the ball players. He gets the ball on the rim, and the rest of the guys will be crossing the board.
That's right, and as we look at the scoring there for the second quarter, like I said, Ruper had 13, Kreis had 8, Joe McDonald had 2 in the second quarter, Joe Amick had 6, and Dave Lacroix had 3. So you can see that you might say untraditionally, we find a few of the unsung players on the Chisholm team.
They're doing the yeoman's job.
That's right. They've tightened up their belts, and they've scored the points when they've had to. And it sure is good to see, like I said again. And that's been the difference in the game.
Well, Harley, let our fans watch our fifth and sixth graders play basketball for 8 minutes. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back on the air in another 8 minutes.
That's right, Phil.
Testing.
boys and ride the win number 7.
Okay, Phil, Chisholm will have the possession starting in the second half over here, and there you see Bubba Kearney going over and shaking Dave LaCroix's hands. That's what I like to see, a little sportsmanship out there in a tough game like this. You can try your hardest to do your best, and you can still be a gentleman about it.
Howie, we have a wrap of Dr. Reagan, who's our statistician. 11 points, McDonald, 12, Cries, 3, LaCroix, Rupert, 13, 8, Amick, Teasing, 13, Kearney, 12, Rasic, 7, 4 for Sadovich, Ani, 4, Kachowski, 2.
That nice pass inside to LaCroix. LaCroix slips inside for that one to get the first 2 points, and the score being 49-42. Streaks go up by 7 points here, Phil. Pass inside, Rupert in
the second. I'll tell you, Holly, I'd rather have the 7 point lead than they down by 7.
Oh, you're not just a kid. Here comes McDonald, top left-hand side of the key. Pumps twice, puts it up, and two more points.
4-0-4, two biggies. A 9 point lead for the Streaks.
51-42.
I'll tell you, if we eliminate those mental mistakes, I'll tell you, we'll be in good shape, Howie.
Yeah.
It's not the basketball skills. There it is, Rupert. Beautiful.
Teasing is a good
nice rebound.
Puts it up, and here comes Teddy
Cruz. This is all the goal. Here we go. Oh, a bad pass. Understand how they don't feel too bad being biased. The report on the Hibbing radio station that they're totally biased in the calling of this game, so I don't feel bad.
Ani up with two, but follows it. Ball there, the basket goes down. Ball by LaCroix. Ani scores two. 51-44. Down to a 7 point lead, that puts Ani to the line for one shot.
Howie, I feel very lucky this second half. I didn't feel bad over at the first game because Paul McDonald once split the pot. That's an omen.
I certainly hope so. There's Ani, makes the bucket. 6 point lead for the Streaks, 51-45 with 6:45 left in the third quarter. Amick with the ball down the far side to McDonald. McDonald eyes the ball, takes a 3-pointer, in and out. Rash comes down with the rebound. Over to Ani. Ani down to Kearney.
There's a mess.
Well, there we see the same call, Phil. You touch that glass when the ball's up there, and that's a technical foul.
No, he said no basket, technical foul. Absolutely right, Ollie. I think these are the Metro calls. Usually these calls go down in the cities because they have taller basketball players down there, Howie, so they kind of have to control the game that way. But here, Chisholm is unusually tall this year. Usually we're those Scandinavian short people. And I'd like to say hi to my mother, Catherine Bober, and her bridge group. They couldn't make it here tonight, but they're playing bridge. I hope they're watching Channel 2. It's an exciting game, and I hope we win, girls.
Okay, Ani on the line to shoot his first of two technical foul shots. Rolls around, no good. By the way, that was David LeCour's second fall of the game. First team fall in this half for the Streaks. Ani puts it up and makes the second one. The lead is cut now to 5 points. And the Blue Jackets get the ball out of bounds at half court. 6:30 remaining in the third quarter.
Oh, that's why I like short guys in the basketball team. They can't get those falls.
Ani eyeing it up out to Kearney at the top of the key. Backs up. Looks at Thiesing over here, but passes back over to Ani.
They got Thiesing running the baseline. They're looking for him. There he is. Three-point land. There. Exactly what McDonald said. Get right in his face.
Kearney back over to Ani on the far side at the top of the three rings.
Nice defense.
Rash turns around for the
nice
ball.
Rebound.
McDonald with another rebound. Good save by McDonald. Coming down the floor on the far side. Takes it into the basket, stops, puts the ball up, and 2 points for Joel McDonald. Brings the lead up to 7 points, 53 to 46.
We're making it.
Two
points.
Play
like a man possessed. I believe it.
I love it. I love it. Y'all. I love it.
Ladies, I like this.
He needs a game like this, and he's certainly having it tonight.
This is the time to have it.
You betcha. Long pass over to.
There's Kreis for two.
No good.
There's Rupar. No. There's Kreis. No. There's Kearney on his back. And he gets called for the ball. And that's what I call excellent officiating.
That ball is going over the back on number 20, Bubba Kearney. That's his second. And the first team foul here for Hibbing. Each team has one team foul so far with 5 minutes, 17 seconds left in the game. In the third quarter.
Oh, I like the 7-point lead. I'm very comfortable with it, but I want to see 10. McDonald has stopped this.
Ani with a fadeaway shot, and Teddy Kreis comes up with a big rebound there. McDonald coming down the floor, taking it down the center. Goes to the left. Stops, puts the ball up, no good. Kreis with the rebound, no good. Kreis with the rebound, and it's 2 more points.
That's one way to get 3 rebounds.
Extending the lead to 9 for the Streaks, 55 to 46 with 4:44 left to go in the third quarter.
A lot of basketball fans left. Let's not get too excited like we are.
Kearney,
we're gonna try to
out to Ani. Ani, nice pass into Thiesing underneath.
There's that mental mistake.
That's
Ollie.
Right.
They're just not looking back.
55 to 48, 7-point lead for the Streaks. Amick with the ball going down the left-hand side over there. Moving it in to the baseline. Can't find anybody to get the ball out to. Over to Rupert. Rupert across court into Teddy Kreis. Left, one pump fake, puts it up and in, and 2 points.
That's a Ted Kreis move.
That is one fine move, Phil. Teasing with a block by Amick. McDonald with the ball coming down the floor over on the right-hand side. Puts up a 3-point shot, and it's down! With the biggest lead of the game for the Streaks. A 12-point lead, 60 to 48.
Oh, and Hibbing is forced to go over to the fans. Listen to this round of applause.
I love it, Bill. It just gets the old adrenaline flowing every time I hear that at a Hibbing Chisholm basketball game. Especially when the Streaks are ahead.
Remember last time when we went to the third quarter, 1 minute left to go in the third quarter, we were ahead by 18, and we lost in overtime. We had many reasons why we lost. We're not going into details. We didn't play smart basketball. But I'll tell you right now, I think we've learned our lesson. I think we should keep building that lead. We're not forcing the ball. We're taking that good shot. But we have a mental lapse out there once in a while, and I'm watching the guy behind us. We're watching the ball, especially those big guys.
You bet, Phil. And one thing I really like to see tonight, this is really a beautiful team effort here tonight. All 5 guys on the floor getting totally involved all the time. Chisholm playing fantastic as a team.
Let's just keep playing solid basketball.
That's
out
right.
And walk away out of here with a win.
Ani out at the far right side into Kearney. Pass into Kraczowski, puts the ball up. Round, no good. Ball comes out to Kraczowski, puts the ball up, no good. Kraczowski.
Oh, no! Oh, that's a good call.
Well, that's a matter of opinion. But anyhow, the call is there. McDonald gets a fall on the block, puts Krzyzewski. Krzyzewski had good position there. He had the point of the basket, Phil, and you know as well as I do, that's 90% of rebounding. If you have good position, you have a heck of a lot better chance of getting that rebound. Krzyzewski misses the first one, so the Streaks hold the lead still at 60-48 with 3:29 left to go in the third quarter. He cans the second one.
Here we have Brian Thompson.
Thompson in for Emick. Now they're going to go with a little taller lineup in there.
Brian Thompson, 6'4" sophomore. Looks like we'll be a little bit more deliberate out there, Howie. We're looking for that opening, right. Working the ball.
Let's go to McDonald, a three-point,
two points.
Rebound comes off to Kearney. Kearney down the center of the court to the timeline. Stops a three-pointer over to Thiessen.
No doubt about it.
Off. The ball is off of Rupert's hands there.
Howie is a good example. He missed the whole basket, but the ball skidded out of Rupert's hands. He had position on it.
That's a tough one to get, Phil, when it comes off like that. Ani taking a shot. Looks like Roops is going to get the fall there.
I'll tell you, we're doing the right things because we're pressuring that shot. They're not getting, we're going to make them win this ball game at the free throw line, Howie.
That's the third foul on, personal foul on Roper there. And the third team foul for us this half. Ani hits the first one. The lead is now 60-50 in favor of Chisholm with 3:01 left. And Ani has his second free throw coming up. It's good. 9-point lead for the Streaks. We got a player coming in. We got Rash. Rash coming back into the game for Krzyzewski. Thompson now taking the ball down the floor over here.
Here we have number 40 against 40, two sophomores.
Into McDonald on this close side over here. McDonald dribbles around, stops, puts the ball up, and dead eye.
Howie, if you notice, there are three guys surrounding Joel McDonald right there.
But he knows when to pull up, Phil, and take that shot.
He couldn't go left, he couldn't go right, he went up. Now that's basketball sense.
62-51 with 2.5 minutes left to go.
Now again, his face. There it is, that ball's skidding.
Yep.
It's either in or out. There's Lacoste.
Good hustle. And a pass. Gets the ball away to Rupert. Back to Thompson. Thompson takes
it. He's bringing it down like a guard, Howie. Number 40.
Yeah. Over to McDonald. He pump fakes a few times. Third time. Passes the ball back out to Ted Kreis. Takes it into the paint.
Oh.
Takes it off the glass. No good.
Here's Thiessing. He can't dribble. There he goes. That's what we want. Air ball. I'll tell you, he couldn't do two things at the same time. Dribble, pull up, and shoot. It's either he shoots, or that's it. Now, if we play smart basketball, Howie, we can take some time off the clock.
That's right.
Get 2 points. Now, there we go. We're forcing it again.
You're right, Phil. We can't force it when we have this kind of lead. Because with the kind of three-point shooters that Hibbing's got, it doesn't take long for them to climb back into the game. Not to say that they're out of it, but we got a cap on them right here.
We had an opportunity three times to score. We can work it in with a minute 40, take a minute off the clock, get the 2 points.
That's right. Here we go now. McDonald's got the right idea, slowing the ball down. 62-51, minute and a half left, 3-point shot, and it's down.
Oh, Howie, I think
so much for that. So much for that, Gary. 65-51.
But he's the only guy that can do it, I'll tell you that.
14-point lead into Rash over to Sadovich, and end up with a 2-point easy shot.
Mental mistake.
53-65. 12-point lead. 1 minute left on the clock.
Now's the time, Howie. Here's the time.
Dakota McDonald. McDonald over to Thompson.
Beauty! What a beauty! Softball!
And here comes Hibbing right back. Ani coming down. No.
Hey, that's okay. We forced the shot.
We missed it. That's right.
You got to put those two in. There's no easy ball, easy baskets anymore.
We forced them to take the tough one, Phil.
And with the first had more shots, Howie, in the last minute than we had when we played for the whole game.
Probably the whole year.
Since I rode the bench, I didn't get any shots.
Now there's Ani. That's the guy you really don't want to put to the line, Phil. He is a deadeye. 67-54 with 54 seconds of the third quarter remaining. And there's the other one. Nothing but net. Back to 12-point lead for the Streaks with 50 seconds left in the third quarter. McDonald putting on a few moves, popping the ball up, no good. Gets his own rebound, puts it back up off the glass and in for two more.
A heck of an effort, here they come. Teasing, on the dribble, he won't shoot on the dribble. There, that's what we usually did in the last minute or so. They're forcing the ball, we're coming down, we're controlling it. We're going for two, Howie, we're going for two.
And with 30 seconds left in the third quarter, we've got a 14-point lead.
Well, we went for three.
Ani over here to Thiesing. Thiesing in the close corner. Ani back in. Nice pass into Rash. Powers in. No good. Flies with the rebound. 10 seconds left on the clock. LeCoe's got the ball. I know he's going in. Gets it stripped off his hand down there. 6 seconds left to go. We got a 14-point lead. It could really put the pressure on the Blue Jackets if we end up scoring a basket here.
Here's that B-team play, Howie.
Yeah.
LeCoe for three, no good. And that ends the third quarter, Howie. Score, Blue Streak, 69, Blue Jackets, 55. Let's listen to the fans, Howie. Give them a standing ovation.
Both teams, audiences here standing up and cheering their teams on. As you well know, there's a capacity crowd here tonight, and the noise is just great in here. Like I said, Phil, it just keeps the old adrenaline flowing, and this is what really makes basketball all that it can be.
As a feature of our game, and most people haven't seen it, that we'll be interviewing a parent after every game. And tonight it will be Mr. and Mrs. Kreis, mother and father of Ted Kreis. Basketball fans, if you're at home, start chewing the popcorn, drink that Coke. We have 8 minutes of non-stop basketball. Let's hope our Blue Streaks are on the top at the end of 8 minutes.
All right, alternate position. Hibbing's got the ball out of bounds. Teasing over to Ani. Center court, crosses the timeline. Looks around.
Then he's got Thiesing running the baseline. There he is. Now, someone's in his face right now.
Back out to Carney. Carney takes it in. Passes off to Kuchelski. Puts the ball up. 2 points. 1 point game. And now Hibbing is putting on some full court pressure here with LeCoe taking the ball down. Heading to the center. Okay. Back out to Kreis. Kreis sees a little lane in there. Tries to drive in. Stops. Puts the ball up and it's 2 points for
Huntsdale. That Ted Kreis is Mr. Basketball tonight, along with the other four basketball players on the court and the two guys that came off the bench. We've got a big lineup out there. Joey Amick is ready to come off the bench.
There's Carney.
There. 6-1, Dave LeCoe
in there for the rebound. Over to Kreis.
We're in no rush right now, Howie. We control the game.
There it is. It's a Rupert. Rupert pumps once, pumps twice. Ted gets the ball, puts it up,
and the finger roll. NBA finger roll.
And the score is 73 to 57.
16 points, Howie.
The biggest lead of the game, Phil. Couldn't be at a better time if you're a Chisholm fan. Well, so much for that lead. They're seizing with a three-pointer. 13-point lead for the Streaks. No, that's what I said. They've got some real three-point bombers. As Yogi Bear always says, chain over till she's over. McDonald lost the ball there. Ani coming down with it. There's Thiesing. Thiesing pumps. Puts it up. No good. Thiesing gets the rebound on the far side. Out to Ani. Overload on that side of the floor with just Rash on this side. Now Thiesing cuts across bottom.
Nice guy out of his face. There he is. He's stopping that shot. Rupert is stopping that shot.
Carney.
There he is. Now Ted has to get out there. There. You stop the baseline on him.
Carney.
Carney.
3-point shot.
And there it is.
There you go. Back to a 10-point ball game. 73 to 63. That's what I said. When you got 3-point shooters, on the team. She ain't over till she's over.
Howie, this is deja vu. 8 unanswered points. As I said at the beginning, I'd rather have an 8-point lead than be 8 points behind. They've outscored us 8-0 within 35 seconds.
You're right, Phil. I'm wondering, is there a violation here? Is there a violation?
No, it's a timeout.
Okay. I thought maybe they called a violation first of all, but hopefully it's blue ball.
5:32 remaining, 8-point lead, streaks ball. We've got to come down and do something. I just don't want deja vu the last two games. We're ahead by 11, 18 points, and we lost by 1 or 2 points.
Like I said, you can hear the crowd here, Phil. They're going wild. She's a barn burner. 73-65 with 5.5 minutes left to go, and Hibbing's putting on full court pressure.
Joey Amick's back in the ball game.
McDonald taking the ball down, setting a pick on Krzyzewski. Making a steal on McDonald, scoring.
Howie, 10 unanswered points. 10 unanswered points.
Cries at the top of the key.
They got us out of our game plan. We're coming down. Momentum switch to the Blue Jackets.
Over to LaCole. And
there's
a
foul.
Foul
number 30.
I believe, Phil. Who's it on?
I think it's 1-1, number 30. No.
That's only the second foul.
A long way before we get to 1-1, Howie.
That's right. McDonald out at the top of the timeline, or the three-point line, dribbling the ball. Ani on him, playing tight. Gets double-teamed now. Over to Kreis. Kreis out to Amick. Amick back to LaCole. Over to McDonald on the side. Eyes up the situation. Takes it in a little bit in the lane. Teddy Kreis with a big rebound there and a must basket.
There they come. They're trying to force it up again, but we're back on defense. But they're seizing wide open. You can't do that. Can't do that. Howie, when are we going to learn to get in that guy's face?
There's a foul on Kearney. And now, with the score 75-70, 4 minutes and 16 seconds left in the game, only a 5-point lead. Went from 16-point lead to 5 points. That's what I said. Hibbing has got some shooters, and if they're hot, you've got to play some tough defense, both outside of that three-point line and inside of it. LaCole calling a play at the top of the timeline. Back over to McDonald. Way out near the timeline.
We're down to 3:59, Howie. We have a 5-point lead.
Taking it in. McDonald puts it up. And it's home.
At this stage, it's anybody's ball game, Howie.
Yep.
We've got the lead. Right now, they have the momentum. If they miss a few shots, we'll take the win out
there
of their sails.
Kearney with a three. No good. And tries with another human rebound.
Now, Howie, let's take some time off that clock.
I think you're right, Phil. We'll have to see what happens.
Let's go for that 2-pointer inside.
Okay, we got a 7-point lead with 3.5 minutes.
There it is.
Going
2 feet away. There's
the ball inside.
Oh,
puts the ball up.
Jump ball possession, Chisholm.
Well, we got a jump ball out of that. I couldn't really see it there, but
being biased, Howie, he fouled him. No doubt about it.
Anyhow, Chisholm gets the ball out. Over to McDonald. 3:20 left. Over to Kreis. Inside to Thompson. Back out to McDonald. Back down to a 5-point lead, Phil.
We took 30 seconds off the clock, but they made a basket in 1 second, so.
There's Roop. Wasik and a foul. 5-point lead with 2:58 left. Rupert got open on the inside, put a fake on, went to go up. Drew the foul. Falls on Teasing. Rupert will go to line to shoot through after Hibbing takes a timeout.
Well, basketball fans, for the first live broadcast that we've had for this year, and first time ever, you have a treat on your hands. We may not be the best announcers, but I'll tell you, we gave you a good basketball game. Especially for those that aren't here. What a treat to tune in and see your two favorite announcers, Howard Janisich and yours truly, Phil Bolger, doing the best they can with the limited abilities that we have. We lost all our mic. Testing.
Testing? Testing?
Yeah, I'm off. Say something.
Yes, Phil.
Well, Howie, I hope we're on the air. We have some technical difficulties. Except, Howie, we don't have the sign to flash to let the people know, so I hope you're hearing me loud and clear.
Right, big bucket here for Roops. Gets two shots.
He's the Iceman, no problem. No problem.
Makes the first one, 6-point lead, 78-72, with a lot of time left. There's 3 minutes left in this ball game.
He's cool, like an ice cold Coke, I'll tell you that right now.
There he is. Another one, drilled it. 7-point lead.
He's my man. 2:53, plenty of time. You gotta get in his face, that's what they're doing. There it is.
What a turnover for Hibbing.
Now, Howie, with 2:44 to go, what can we do?
Well, I'll tell you, Phil, you and I both...
We always guess wrong, so what should we guess this time?
Well, we're going to guess that they should hold on to the ball, eat some time off the clock here. But we've been wrong at this so many times that maybe this time we'll be right, Phil. Who knows? Thompson on the outside, eyes it. Takes one dribble in, eyes it. Back out to Price. Price in.
I know something. Every time they put the ball down, they're going for the ball. They want the ball, the Blue Jackets. There we go. Bringing everybody out. They're saying, come and get me. Come and get me. We're down to 2:10. This is not very exciting, but this one has to be done. Well, we made the boo-boo. He threw it off his knees. If the Lord wants us to have hands on their knees, he put them there, right, Holly?
You betcha. But there's 2 minutes left here, Phil. We've got the lead by 7. That's not much. You consider it's heavy. Kraczewski with the ball. Puts it up. Back down to 5 points. So the 1:50 left to go, Phil.
Don't leave your TV sets. We're going to have a last minute barn burner. I just feel it. If you haven't called a friend, pick up that phone. Tell them to tune in.
It's too late to pick up the phone, so. 1:32 left. 79-74.
Dave Lacoste's been hurting tonight. He has that hip pointer. He's not as mobile as he used to be. He's getting better every day. But I just hope that magic touch is in his wrist, Howie.
Well, he's got to make the front end of this thing, Phil. That's the main thing. Because if you don't make the front, of course, it's obvious. You don't get the back end of it.
Howie, brilliant.
And with only a 5-point lead with 1:30 to go. There's the
Joe rebound.
Big rebound. Big rebound. There's a foul. Ioni.
Howie, I'll take 2 points for every foul they want to give at us. How about you?
You betcha.
I'd rather have the clock slip down to 29 seconds, but we're here chewing our gum. Stay tuned, basketball fans. Till after the game, we'll have a live interview with Pat and Denny Fries.
There's that run into the 1-1, 6-point lead with 1:30 left to go.
Now, also watch TV on Channel 2 for times that we will rebroadcast the last two Chisholm games.
And there's the second one. McDonald here, he'll go to the line. There's only 45 seconds left, 83-77. Shane over till she's over, but this would help if he gets this one in there.
There it is.
Well, Phil,
and look. Lost it again. Go ahead.
I don't know, do we have it yet?
No, we're back on.
I know one thing, Phil. I told the boys if they beat Hibbing tonight, I buy the pizzas. It looks like I'm buying.
I hope you ordered them already, Holly.
They're ordered and on the way, Phil.
Now we've got to get on them.
Got to think positive.
Oh, it's there. Oh, it's there. Here we go.
You know, Phil, I mentioned about this ball
early in the B-squad game, so I don't know if you noticed it or not, but I noticed that even the players from both sides are having trouble controlling this ball. Maybe it's a brand new ball.
I don't know. Unless there's too much air in the ball. Like I said, I've seen that happen before. I watched Joel now three or four times, and some of the Hibbing players, they just kind of lose control of the ball.
I hope the officials are checking that ball before the game. Now, there has to be an interesting story between these two officials. Why would we get two officials from St. Louis Park? I just don't understand. No, there has to be a history. Because we do pay mileage for these officials. You're not going to pay 400 miles. There's a reason why they're here.
I think these officials have done an excellent job tonight, but they also reiterate.
You're on the school board, you say that. No, it's a matter of there was some tension having Hibbing referees for that last Hibbing game, and they wanted that eliminated. Yeah, but the way the school system runs, these officials are picked 1 year in advance, and where these came from, these were not the schedule, I don't believe, the officials that were scheduled to referee this game a year ago.
I also heard that that these guys call up Cambridge and offer their services to come up. Mike McDonald, the head coach of Cambridge. And so, through recommendations, whatever, I don't know about the change or why it was made, but that's generally the reason.
And basketball fans, I'm not saying there was a change made, but I understand there was Jack Hume and who was the other official scheduled? No, Jack Hume from the other side of the range, I believe, was scheduled, but I don't know that for a fact. And maybe at the next basketball game, we can get Mr. Larkin, our athletic director, to explain the details if there was a switch in officials.
That's the rush. Phil is at the line here for 1-1. Hits the front end. Makes it 85-78. 7-point lead. And there's still 30 seconds left in the game, Phil.
Okay, 7-point lead, 6-point lead. 20 seconds left.
Big rebound by Thompson. Over to McDonald. Dunk it, Ted.
There it is. That's the ball game. And I hear a large lady singing.
Are you mean to tell me that you hear the fat lady singing?
Yes, it's not over until you hear the fat lady sing. Let's listen.
Ooh. I hear a humming anyhow.
It is. It's over, fans. I don't care what they put in now. This basketball game is history. It's bye-bye, American Pie. A howitzer. Another howitzer. That's the game.
And she's over. 87-78. The Blue Streaks have come through tonight here for the hometown fans. What a game, folks.
Holly, well, Hopi basketball fans, stick around. We're going to have the wrap-up of tonight's basketball game, points scored, and then an interview with Dennis and Pat Price, parents of Ted Price.
Well, basketball fans, we're back. The score is still 87-78, as you can see.
I had some information to give to you. The next basketball game that will be televised, we hope, if we can borrow a piece of equipment from the city, will be this Friday against McGregor, who also has an excellent basketball team. And the next Hibbing Chisholm game will be played in Hibbing at the Lincoln on February 19th. So stick around. We're going to have an interview and a wrap-up right after a few messages from our sponsors. Again, Larnick's Big Dollar, Casey Drug, John Raleigh Logging, Dale Rakita Insurance, Dave Zanardi Pharmacy in Grand Rapids. And next time I'll give you a whole list of other advertisers. If you wish to advertise, call Phil Bulver at 254-4136. We'll gladly get your name on TV.
Testing.
What a man.
Testing, testing, testing. Hello, hello. We're coming back on.
I don't have enough. I know, can you get me? Okay.
Give me. Well, instead of just standing here like a doofus, I'm waiting for Dennis and Pat, who are just here. Can you hear me, Sean? Okay, why don't you give me that, the unofficial statistics for tonight's game. McDonald had a total of 33 points. Ted Kreis, 24. Dave LeCole, 5. Mike Rupar had 15 biggies, and I don't know how many rebounds. Joey Amick, a big 8 points. And Brian Thompson, 2 points. Now, I'll tell you one thing, points do not tell the entire story. There's defense that's being played out there, rebounds, very important. For Hibbing, Carney had 14, Aoni 15, Feasing. That's a young sophomore, hit those 3 points, 28, Ratch, 8, Kraczowski, 7, and Sadovich, 6 points. Right now, I have with me, I think we can get everybody up here, Dennis and Pat Kreis. Now, Sean, I'll stand down here. There we go. I think we can see yourself on TV. That's okay. No, you can stand. That's fine. Right on my left, we have Pat and Dennis Kreis, parents of Ted Kreis. And I think the fans in Chisholm, since this is our first live broadcast, would like to know a little information of where you've been, what you've been doing, where you've come from, how many kids you have. I know a little of that background, not much, but I'll just let you talk and let the people of Chisholm know what's going on in your life.
Okay, originally my family's from Aurora, Minnesota, but we spent 35 years up in Fairbanks, Alaska, and moved to Bohabik in 1979. We have 4 children, 3 daughters, and Ted's the youngest one, the boy. I'll let my wife say a few words now.
The boy, that about says it all. Yeah, Denny. We're a basketball family. We watch every game that's on television that we can, and our daughters all play basketball in high school. 2 of them played in college, and I guess you call us basketball junkies.
I think you have 3 daughters?
Yep.
And they all attended college?
Yes,
and graduated? And what colleges did they attend?
My oldest daughter, Karen, attended UMD.
Computer science major.
Yeah, computer science major. My middle daughter, Kim, was a math major, graduated from College of St. Benedict. My youngest daughter, Kathy, was an accountant, and she graduated from St. Ben's also, and those 2 daughters also played basketball at St. Ben's.
Pat and Ted, I really don't know the story of why you moved to Chisholm. There's always speculation. I think the people of Chisholm should know the whole entire story of how Ted and Joel and Mr. McDonald met and what possessed you to move to Chisholm.
The main reason we moved to Chisholm was not for basketball, like everybody says. Basketball did play a small part, but we were dissatisfied with having to move our son from Bohabik to the Aurora High School. That was it in a nutshell. We didn't like the system, since they only have a 6-hour period day in Aurora, and a college-bound student has a very difficult time getting the proper courses in a 6-hour day. That was the number one reason. Then naturally, he is a basketball player, and Bob McDonald asked us after his sophomore year if Ted would like to go to the Star of the North games and play with Chisholm, and that he did. But we were thinking of making a move prior to this ever happening, only we didn't know at the time it would be to Chisholm, but we knew we were going to make a move from the Mesabi School District.
I think the pairing is sharing. The same thing happened over at Evelyn Gilbert High School. Right now you have 5 Gilbert kids starting. Some kids fall by the wayside and are not happy with the system and just give up. And what happened here is that it just chances by luck and by golly that Mr. McDonald did invite you and I think your son and some other players to go down and play. And I think what happened was that you saw Chisholm as being a friendly town. You saw Chisholm being a good basketball town, and Ted really developed his skills not only in the classroom but also on the basketball court.
I'd like to say one other thing. I hope the people in Chisholm realize what a jewel they have in Bob McDonald. This man is a true educator, and all the time that he spends, not only just in basketball, but in youth recreation, and he puts in the time, believe me, and whatever they're paying him isn't enough, because he puts in far more hours in a day than he's ever getting paid for.
I know for a fact, being on the school board, the money he makes is just basically for basketball. Does not include Saturday basketball, driving the kids all over the range, Sunday open gym, summertime. Even though he does run the rec department, he has to have supervision. And in Chisholm, we didn't have the money to pay it as a rec department. And he's been going along all these years doing it for gratis. And there's a lot of articles written in the paper about this and that, but people really don't understand what the background is. If your son wants to play basketball in Chisholm, if he wants to practice, Mr. McDonald, Coach McDonald, will give you the opportunity to prove yourself. If you don't practice, basically, you won't play. I think that's what life's all about.
He's just teaching these young kids in the age they're at now what they're going to face when they get out in the world. But in order to get ahead, you got to work for it and apply yourself. And all the things he teaches are the lessons that they're going to have to put into practice when they go out into the world.
I know when I was coaching boys basketball in Evelyn, Ted was a sophomore. He was a ninth grader and a sophomore, and we knew he was going to be a good basketball player. But I think what happened here, there was a chemistry between Joel and the rest of the players, and they came down here and they played together. And not only did they play together, they go out and have fun together. And I think that's what the second part about basketball is, camaraderie. I know tonight Howie Janisich ordered 10 pizzas from Pizza Hut, and they're all going out, and Coach McDonald lifted the curfew at, from 9:30 to whenever. So what are, you know, so there is compassion. I'm glad we're happy. I'm glad we're doing this interview after a victory and not a loss.
I think beating Hibbing had something to do with this also, this euphoria, because this is an excellent win for our ball club.
Unofficially, Ted had 24 points, but mostly he stole the ball. He had the rebounds. I don't know what the rebounds were. He was an effort. He had 20 rebounds tonight. Rupar, have you ever seen Mike Rupar play basketball like this before?
You know, we've been waiting and waiting for Mike to finally start making that progress and start playing like a senior. Tonight, he finally arrived. I would honestly say if it wasn't for Mike Rupar, we wouldn't have won the ball game, because he not only got, 10 or 12 points. Okay, 13 points, but he also had some key interceptions. He got a few key rebounds, and that is the difference in this game, is what he contributed.
I think you also, you're a modest man, but you worked with Mike Rupar and Ted this summer out of your garage and had him lift weights just to be that much stronger. So Joel McDonald was there lifting weights. Not only lifting weights, but then they came to the gym. So you had something to do with the strength of Mike Rupar. And I think what's happened is that the rest of the fans now are behind Mike and the team 100%, and you're going to see by broadcasting these games, there's going to be a fan following, I hope, down to the state basketball tournament.
Hopefully, but you never know what's going to happen. We take them one at a time, and tonight is just a tremendous victory for these kids, and I hope they build on it now, that this game tonight showed them how to play good team ball, that they use everybody, and against a good team. And this could be the start now of coming together and reaching that peak that you want to reach when you go into district play.
I think the last two games, we were ahead by 18 points going in the third quarter with 1 minute to go. Then Joel got hurt. The year before that, we're ahead by 11 points and someone got hurt, and it was Joel again. And they took us out of our game. But now you saw the guys with the big lead, slowing the ball down, working in for the good shot. And there at the end, Ted was open and bango, 2 points, and that was the ball game.
Yeah, I think the big difference between this game against Hibbing tonight and the game that we played them in the Hibbing tournament was our legs were here in the fourth quarter in this game. In that tournament game, we were exhausted in the fourth quarter. We had three grueling games in 3 days. We don't have a long bench. Our regulars don't get much of a break. And I think that was the difference. In that game, we were running on empty in that fourth quarter. Tonight, we had our legs in the fourth quarter, and we held on to win it.
Okay, anytime you play three AA schools when they can bring in five at a time at you, you're just going to get worn down. And what happened tonight, there was a AA school. They played eight or nine guys. We played eight or nine guys, and we were victorious. Again, we play them, I think, on February 19th. But this was a big game because this gives them three losses in the IRC. We have no losses. We could have clinched the IRC championship if we go along and beat the rest of the teams, and so did they. So it was a big game.
Yeah, I think tonight, I'm pretty sure that this could clinch the IRC championship for Chisholm, and this has been a 10-year dry spell for that IRC championship, so it's really a tremendous victory for our kids. And you got to give Bob McDonald credit again. He had these kids prepared for this game tonight. He knew what the strengths of Hibbing are in that, and he had them well coached, and they executed for him.
Well, I thank you very much for stopping by, and I appreciate this. I hope the Chisholm fans got to know you a little bit better, and good luck to Ted and the rest of the boys.
Thank you for the opportunity to come and talk with you.
We appreciate it.
Very welcome.
We're very happy here.
Well, you heard it from, we're not going to say an outsider, we're going to call him a hometown boy, Dennis and Pat Kreis. Had the choice of coming to Chisholm, they could have moved anyplace else. Chisholm is a wonderful place to live. Recapping, again, Chisholm did win the basketball game. I'd like to thank Sean Bober, our cameraman, Julian Janicic, our statistician, and who was the other statistician, Sean?
Overstone.
What's her first name? Well, we didn't get the names right. Howie Janicic, our play-by-play, and I'd like to thank myself. I don't know why, because nobody else will thank me. And Novoselic, Tommy Novoselic, for stopping by and doing the girls' game, boys' games, and everything else. So, I'd like to say adieu, I'm tired, au revoir. Hope to see you Friday night. Watch Channel 2 for announcements of when we're going to rebroadcast the other games. Hopefully, we'll be able to do it on our own set. Right now, we're at the mercy of the City Hall. So, if you have any complaints, call the City Hall. Thank you, and good night.